So we're here in front of Standing Rock, and as you can see, the banner that says "From Palestine to Standing Rock, we're united" is here. Like other occupied people of America, the Americas, Palestine's the only actually country or people here that's outside of the United States. The rest is native people, as far as we can see. And I think that really speaks to this campaign, Palestine to the pipeline. That really, the issues of water and land and sovereignty are so united with this cause at Standing Rock. So we hope you'll join. On the 5th, they're supposed to be evacuated.
They're standing strong.
Standing strong, and I guess a lot of veterans and police, retired police officers, are planning on coming and being on the front lines. And so right now is an important time to even come out to support, so that this resistance can continue. And it's really just their presence is a resistance here, because land has been taken and rights have been taken away. And Adalpa is just the next reiteration of this. So it's a pretty important time to come.
Please support, please help. If you can do anything, you can.
It's cold, you have to bring a...
Visit this camp. Call your congressman. Donations.
Divest from Wells Fargo, Chase.
Yep. And Bank of America.
There's great credit unions. I've been at the Orange County Credit Union Schools First for 17 years. I'm proud to be a member.
Mm-hmm. It's time to transfer your money from a bank to a credit union.
Support local communities. If you could see off in the distance, where's Turtle Island? Over there, that's where the police are standing on Turtle Island on the top of the hill. And that's where the pipeline's coming in. So that is the front line there. We were there yesterday, and we'll probably go back today to check it out. So that's where that and the bridge of Highway 1806. This is the Highway 1806, right behind us. That's where all the cars are coming in. That was blocked. Last night we actually took that road all the way to the blockage, and they the Army Corps of Engineers or the police or whoever, this construction, blocked it off. So it was like a 25-minute drive from Bismarck. Instead, if you wanted to go from Bismarck, which is the biggest city with the airport, it takes an hour and a half to get here. So consider time and energy and travel and ease of, you know, gas money, everything like that has become way more complicated. So this is just one roadblock they're trying to do for the activists that are here, or the people that are here to stand with Standing Rock. But obviously it's not stopping them. You can see there's a line of, there's a line of cars. The camp is always changing. People are coming and going. And so one thing that's consistent is you're always welcomed. And everybody's here to support each other. And so when you come here, if you come with the Palestinian Youth Movement and Activate Labs and Arab American Civic Council, Megan Awad is here to welcome you, and she'll be setting you up and making sure that you have a campsite. You just have to bring all your things, a tent and warm clothes and warm things. Although they do have some donation that if you did miss something, you could maybe try to fill it up. One thing that I had missed that something is, if you're a woman, you might want to bring a skirt. It's considered Holy Land in Lakota culture. Women wear skirts, so that was an important aspect that I had to go find a skirt, actually. So there's a lot of other details we'll try to put up for you all. Mostly you could do it from your own home. And there's Megan. All right.
All right.
I'm gonna peace out now. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.